Hello everyone, this is Reza Dorani. In this video, we will look at how we can leverage the patch function in PowerApps to efficiently perform bulk operations, bulk edit, bulk copy, and bulk delete with respect to our data source. I will cover two scenarios in this video, one with Microsoft Dataverse as a data source, and second with SharePoint as a data source. Let's get started with this video, but first, my introduction. So the first scenario with relation to bulk operations will be with Microsoft Dataverse as a data source. I have a task portal based app. I have a table that I have created in Dataverse called task. And as part of this table, I have the name, which is the primary column of type text. I have an auto number column called ID, which automatically generates the ID of the task. I have assigned to as an email type. I have the due date, start date of the task, and then I have a couple of choice columns. One is called priority, and the other one is task status. Now, as part of my Power App right here, I have a gallery that I have created that is showcasing all the data from my Dataverse table tasks. And right here, I can filter my records based on the status of the task. Currently, there are 45 records in my task list. If I filter this by status in progress, I have 41 that are in progress, I have no deferred records, I have 4 completed, and there are currently no tasks that are currently not started. So this is basically a filter of the status of my task, a very common scenario wherein you have a gallery and you can define multiple filters. Now what I want to show first is how we typically perform bulk operations. And what do I mean by bulk operations is I would like to modify multiple records. Maybe I would like to update them. Maybe I want to copy records. Maybe I want to delete records. And in most of the cases, what we do is this. I have a gallery right here. And in this gallery, I have gone ahead and added a checkbox. When the checkbox is checked, I am collecting this item into a collection. And when the checkbox is unchecked, I am removing this item from the collection. And this gallery, the data is coming from my tasks list, and this is my Dataverse table. That means if I start selecting records, these are getting added to my collection. And if I uncheck them, they will be removed from my collection. Now, let's say in this scenario, I will go ahead and look at all the tasks that are currently in progress. I have 41 in progress tasks. And let's say I would like to go ahead and make modifications to all of these items that are currently in progress status. I've created this button called check all. And basically when I check this, it just goes and checks all. I have a button right here that I have created. And this is typically what we use. On select of this button, all I'm doing is I'm going to the collection that I am creating when the checkbox is checked. And for each of the items in this collection, that's why I've put my condition as true, I have this column called task status. I am updating this column with the value in this dropdown. So basically right now, I want to bulk update the status of my items in the gallery. That's all I want to do. I'm just taking one simple scenario. Of course, we can add multiple cases right here, but I'm just updating one column in that collection. And once I update that collection, the next thing what I'm doing is I am starting a timer because I want to calculate how long this action is going to take. I want to prove that this is not the most efficient way of doing this. So I've just created a variable that has the current date and time. And I'm creating a collection that includes only these two columns right now. Now, what are these two columns? I have a column called task ID and I have a column called task status. Now I am updating the task status. So if I head back to my Dataverse table, if I look at my task status column, that's the internal name of the column right here. And that's exactly what I have selected in my show columns. That means this collection will include this column. And then I have another column that has the task ID associated with it. Now, what is this task ID? That is the unique identifier or the primary key of the table. So for my table, if I look at the unique identifier or the primary key, the internal name associated with that column is right here. And that is exactly what I have provided in show columns. That means this time my collection is going to only include two things, the primary key, which will give me the details of that record. And the next thing is the status column. Now, this is what we typically do. We have a collection, we do for all. So I'm running through all the items of this collection and then we perform a patch. Now, once this patching is performed, all I'm doing next is I'm again going and calculating how long has this entire action taken from this point to this point. And I'm noting that also in a variable. And finally, I'm clearing out my collection because the action has been performed. So let's go ahead and play this app. Right now, I have 41 items selected. I will change the status of all of these tasks right now to completed. And I will select this button, which will patch using the ForAll technique. And once I select this, this will start patching all the items and updating the status to completed. Now the ForAll function in PowerApps runs serially. So right now it is patching all of these records one by one by one by one. And if you notice, it took 17 seconds for it to go ahead and patch all the records in my data source. Now if I head over to the completed tab now, I now have 45 records as completed. Right? These are the total number of items right now in my task list. Now, if I select all of this again, let's say I change the status back to in progress. And once again, I execute patch. Again, the same action is going to take place. It's going to start patching the records one by one by one. Not the most efficient way of doing things. There are multiple queries that are going on in the back end against my data source. So as you can see, this entire operation took 19 seconds for it to complete. All of my tasks are now in the in-progress status. Okay, so what is the more efficient way of doing this? Now, once again, if I select check all, it's going to add all the items in the collection. So I have all my 45 items in the collection, but this time I will change the status again to completed. However, instead of using the patch for all technique, let's look at what this button does. For this button, once again, I'm executing the same steps. I am updating the collection. I'm updating the value of the task status. That's the column value I want to change. And then I am starting my timer again. And this time I am calling patch, right? I'm calling patch, but notice there's no for all. I am patching my data source directly with the collection. This collection is being created when I check an item in the gallery. And the gallery items are coming from that same data source. So when I check the checkbox, I am collecting the entire record into this collection. And that's why right here, when I'm executing patch, I can directly patch that entire collection where I just updated the task status. And next, my steps are the same. I'm just counting how long does this action take. And finally, I'm going ahead and clearing the collection. So this time I have 45 records selected. I am going to change the status to completed. Now, when I select update 45 records, let's see how long does this action take. I selected this and that's it. 2 seconds. It took 2 seconds for this action to be completed. That means it's actually performing all of these operations in one go. It's a batch operation. And the reason why I can do that is because I can provide the entire collection to that action. Look at the gain in performance. This action took 19 seconds and this action took 2 seconds. Imagine a scenario where I have 100 records selected, right? It's going to take more and more time in the for all technique purely because it's going to execute every action one by one. Whereas if I batch records, I can just directly assign my collection to the patch function and I can patch everything efficiently. Now, if I head over to completed, of course, all of my records have now been updated and moved to the completed status, as you can see right here. Now, next scenario is, what if I want to copy records, right? I want to duplicate existing records. So in this case, I have some tasks right here, which is learn Power Apps, Power Automate, Power Virtual Agents, and Power BI. And all of these tasks have been assigned to Reza. However, my use cases, I would like to recreate these tasks. Basically copy the existing record and create another record on the fly, but this time assign it to a different user. Let's say I would like to assign this to another user in my organization called Rahul, right? So in this case, I'm saying that assign this to Rahul and keep the status for Rahul as not started. And these are the 4 tasks that I would like to copy. So in order for me to execute the copy action and at the same time update a few properties, If you look at this button now, right here, I'm again updating the collection, right? And what is the collection? The items that were checked. Then I'm updating the status of the task to the status that's selected in the dropdown, and the assigned to column as part of that collection, which is coming from my data source, I am assigning it to the people picker column value that was selected right here. Okay, so that is going to update my collection. The next thing what I'm doing right here, if you notice, I am creating a collection once again. This is my data that I want to patch. And this time I'm using a function called drop columns. Now, drop columns basically drops a column from your specific collection that you're providing right here. In my case, I'm providing this collection and I'm dropping the column task ID. Now, what is this column? If I head back to my task table, this column is the primary key or the unique identifier. That means I am actually dropping the primary key and then patching my collection. If I do this, if I drop my primary key and try and patch the collection, PowerApps understands that you're trying to create an item. If I give the primary key, then it will update the item. So in the previous scenario, when I was updating, I did not drop any column. I just used the entire collection because that collection had the value of the primary key. In this case though, I am dropping the primary key purely because I want to create a record. In this case, I'm literally copying that record and creating a new item. And finally, what I'm doing next, just patching that collection back to my data source. So let's go ahead and test this out. I'm going to play this. I have selected these four tasks. I'm going to set their status to not started, and I'm going to assign all of these to Rahul. And right here, I'm going to go ahead and add my records. And once I select this, remember, it's patching and it's performing everything in batch format. And just like that, if I now head over to not started, I will see four new records that got created right here. As you can see, these are my four records that got created. And if you observe, all of these four records that got created right here have been assigned to Rahul. So these are the tasks assigned to Rahul, and everything else, all the other values are kept intact purely because I just modified a couple of properties that were status and assigned to. So that's how you can copy records and create new records in bulk. And finally, if you want to remove records, once again, I will just check these four items or these four tasks that I just created. And let's say I would like to remove these from my data source. Just use the remove function, provide the name of your data source, pass the collection, and that's it. It will remove all those items. Why? Because it contains the primary key right now. I am not dropping any columns right here, and it will go ahead and remove those items. So if I click on remove, it will go ahead and delete all those four records in one go. So that's how you can efficiently go ahead and build batch processing operations. So you can perform bulk updates, additions, copy, removal, all of these tasks you can perform in PowerApps by using the simple technique of patching and passing your collection that you are creating from your data source. In my case, I'm creating it when I select an item in my gallery. Now, as part of my second demo right here, I am selecting SharePoint as a data source because I want to also show how the same concept works with SharePoint. In my case right here, I have an employee information portal wherein I have the name of my employee, job title, t-shirt size, which university they belong to, department, skill, and status. And right here in SharePoint as well, I will go ahead, let's say in this case, I'm going to select all of my records. In this case, I have 50 records. And let's say I'm going to keep the status as approved. I'm going to keep their skills as Power Apps for all of them, and t-shirt size, let's say I'm going to change it to medium. Now I'm going to perform that same ForAll function patch technique that we typically use. If I select this, what's going to happen? It's going to start updating all those 50 records one at a time. It's executing all of these actions one by one by one. And this in totality has taken 16 seconds to execute. As you can see, all the items in my gallery now have the t-shirt size as medium. Now let's try and do the same thing again. I'm going to select all these 50 items, but this time I'm going to change the t-shirt size, let's say, to small for all these records. And I'm going to use my technique of patching the entire collection. Now, once I select this, it's going to send all of the data in bulk to my data source. But this is SharePoint, even though at the back end it's batching and sending all that content, it still executes at the server side one at a time. But as you can see, it's still a lot more performant than the ForAll technique that we typically use. So from a performance gain standpoint, I would still say there is a good 50% increase in performance. Now let's look at the formula that I used for updating the collection. Once again, I have my collection and I am updating the status, skill, and the shirt size of for that collection. Then I'm going ahead and I'm creating another collection and I'm just including the columns that I need. This is purely to improve performance. Just send those columns that you truly want to update. Remember, in SharePoint, ID is the primary key. Because I'm updating records, I have to pass the primary key. And that's exactly what I'm using in show columns. I am passing the primary key. And along with that, I'm passing the three columns that I would like to update, which is the status, skill, and the shirt size. And finally, once I'm done with that, I'm patching my data source with this collection. And that's how you can perform bulk updates. Now, for bulk creation of items in SharePoint, let's go ahead this time and let's say I pick these two items. I'm going to change the status to pending. I am going to set this to Power Automate. T-shirt size is extra small. And this time I want to create two duplicate records. Basically, I want to create copies of these. Now, once I did this, notice right here, I have those two records created for me. And let's look at the formula for the copy action. Note right here, I'm again updating the collection. And notice right here, when I do show columns for my collection, I am not including the ID column. I'm selecting the columns I need. Alternatively, I could have also gone ahead and dropped the ID column. The key here is if the primary key is present as part of the collection, it will update the record. If the primary key is not present, it will create a record. That's the trick in both the scenarios for Dataverse and SharePoint. And finally, if I would like to go ahead and delete records, so let's say in this case, I will go ahead and pick these two same records that I just created and click on remove. It's gone ahead and deleted the records. Same concept as before. And once again, for the remove function, I am selecting my data source, which is my SharePoint list, and passing the collection, which has the items that I would like to remove. So that's how you can perform bulk operations in an efficient way in Power Apps with SharePoint as a data source or Microsoft Dataverse as a data source. The same concept even applies to SQL as a data source. If you like this video, then do like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching.